Hello and welcome back again. So, training session, endurance, 2.5 hours. Now, I did say in my previous film I was potentially going to do this on the mountain bike, but I wanted to get good sleep, recover, and to get to the forest, drive 35 minutes, get all my gear on, start, get back, get all the gear off, covered in mud no doubt, and then drive back. So, probably looking at about 1.5 hours lost, whereas that's half the session time that I need to do. Weather's not too bad, but I'm going back on Zwift again, and the reason being is when you're on the road, you've obviously got your climbs where you're knocking out power, but then you've got descents, flats, towns, villages, traffic lights, junctions. So you can be out doing a 3-hour ride, as I've said in previous films, but when you get back, the actual riding time and the effort is much lower. Whereas 3 hours on Zwift is a full on 3 hours, no time wasting, no freewheeling, constant power, grinding out minute after minute. So yeah, I'll go do road rides, yes I'll go do mountain biking, and that's just for bike technical handling abilities and to be out in the traffic. But in terms of the actual training gains and the training aspect of progression and getting better and fitter, 90% of that for me comes from indoors. And it's literally just because time crunch factors. If I had the option to train 20 hours a week, it would be on the road, no questions asked. But because I only have anywhere between 6 and 15 hours per week, 15 hours being like really, really unusual, you know. I haven't done 15 hours in a week for a long time working full time. Unless I've been on holiday or had the odd day off on holiday. So, yeah, it's usually between 6 and 10 hours per week. So every second counts. So today is just a cruise, but a cruise 170 to 200 watts. I'm 61 kilos, so for me that's like 2.8 to 3 watts per kilo. So I'm going to be doing that for 2.5 hours. But I can do that talking away. So for example, just now my heart rate is currently 137 as I'm talking to you just now. My cadence is 94 and I'm sitting at 165 watts. So I've got Vegan Cyclist's latest film on. I've got all my data and the course I'm on in Zwift. Phone, nutrition, products, Kaleva. So it's just a case of getting on right now. So, yeah, we'll see you when it's done.
It wasn't like I was actively chasing him, I just felt better when we caught him. And then we're training. It's currently 3 a.m. Got 460 kilometres on the clock. That's the sea!
Okay, so 57 minutes of the endurance session left. I'm sweating. I've got TV on with cycling documentaries just for background noise and comfort, and we're just following the power on Zwift, as you've seen. So what I've had to eat so far has been Nature Valley cocoa hazelnut butter, very good. And now we're about to drop the bad boy with there being 56 minutes left, which is the Kaleva Cola caffeine gel, 70 grams. This contains caffeine, electrolytes, B vitamins. So we're about to drop that bomb now and finish the final leg. So, catch up.
Make that time back.
Okay, so that is endurance session finished. Training stress score 138, 2.5 hours, 80.7 kilometres, so all good. So endurance finished, that's another one ticked off the list. Monday is a rest day, well at work and a rest day. So yeah, we'll see how that goes. So thank you very much for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.